What's up, everybody? I know I haven't been around for a while, but we're gonna continue LA Noire today. I am under the weather. I'm sick again. But I forgot where we left off, so we're just gonna play from this point. I guess we did this already. Yeah, we did do this already, so. Let's check our.
Car 11K, go ahead.
11K, see the janitor. A green 1946 coupe registered to a Mrs. Hugo Mower has been found in the parking lot adjoining the Belmont High School and playing fields. 11K, code 2.
11K, in route. Step on it. Not exactly the happiest of places, the coroner's office.
Carruthers is a good man, professional, diligent. If you're working with a pro, it's easy to overlook the grim realities of a place like that.
Funny job, that. Coroners.
How so?
No, you don't want them enjoying their work too much. The wrong kind of man can get awfully lonely rattling around a joint full of corpses.
Rusty, that's like something out of the pulps.
Been reading the same ones as me?
I thought you were usually too drunk to get through a magazine.
You know, if I close one eye and squint, you can just about make out the print.
Let's see where that is. I want to try to get as much of this game in as I can. What is this gun? Crime scene. And where am I? Yeah, it's too far. Whatever. Apparently I drive way better when I'm sick for some reason. Alright, so we came to a little girl's high school, obviously. We're trying to find out some more information about why the mother didn't show up to pick up the kid and shit.
This is the car?
Yes, sir, detective.
Have you looked it over?
Superficially. I was told to wait for you guys.
Thanks. We'll take it from here. What time did you see the person park the car?
Late last night, after school social, maybe 1 a.m. I've been keeping a good eye out lately. We've had problems with the child molester.
This was the same man?
I don't know, sir. I mean, I'd like to say yes, but truth is, it was pretty dark.
All right. Tell me about this man you've been having trouble with.
He hangs near the playground, tries to befriend the children. He was around here last night before the dance.
Is he violent?
Yes, sir. I would say so, yes. There's the son of a bitch now! Hey, you!
Go, Phelps. I'll take the car.
Of course. Come on, you old fuck. Maybe I can catch this guy. He's not that fast. Come here, you asshole. Why don't I run as fast as everybody else? You stole some kid's panties. We gotta get him.
Hi,
Oh, I got you, bitch. Took him from behind like a true bro.
What's your name?
Who's asking?
Yo, mama.
You do this the easy way or the hard way?
Name's Eli Rooney.
You've been in trouble with the law before, Eli?
Some.
What are you doing around here?
I like to keep an eye on the children.
Strictly paternal, is it, Eli?
Don't sass me, boy.
A woman was abducted here last night, Eli, and murdered.
And I would love to make you for that, you okie motherfucker.
Well, I wouldn't know nothing about that. A woman, you say? I like them a little younger than that.
Turn out your pockets, Eli.
Now, why would I do that?
Because I'm about to break your fucking skull, Eli.
You're under arrest, Eli. You are in very deep trouble.
Butterfly brooch.
Why bother with the paperwork, Eli? I'm going to take out my gun, and I'm going to count to five. Let's see how fast you can run now.
Hang on a goddamn minute. I found that thing in the parking lot.
Get some backup out here, Rusty. We need to get this one downtown and into a cell.
I'll tell them we got a kitty raper coming in. They can roll out the red carpet.
Sick fuck. There's way too many pedophiles in this game. Let's check the fucking car.
Blood and skin samples. We better get Ray Pinker out here.
Looks like one of the rope types that matched up. Bloody overalls.
The overalls are stenciled HM. Muller is a mechanic. I wonder what Eli does for a living.
It's from a Chrysler. Could be important.
I thought the father was the main suspect, but apparently there's more to this. So I wonder where all that blood came from on the father's boots that he went and burned them. And ran. Maybe they were both in on it. Oh, this isn't even my car. I need to go take my car. Auto enthusiast. Alright, so these, obviously these investigations are getting tougher. I'm a shark
queen. 11 King calling KGPL.
It's KGPL, go ahead, 11 King.
We found evidence in a vehicle at Belmont High School, 1575 West 2nd Street. We need Ray Pinker and a tech services team.
Roger, 11 King.
Also requesting interrogations be set up at Central for both suspects currently being held in the Mueller case, KGPL.
11 K, Roger. KGPL.
Yeah, I need the location.
My gut says Mueller. We caught him trying to destroy evidence in his backyard, and that was his car with bloody tools in it.
I never said it wasn't Mueller. Hell, he probably killed his wife, deprived that poor kid of a mother. But he's not in immediate danger to anyone else. Rooney's a threat to every kid at Belmont.
He's a peeper, Rusty. We can pick him up for something else.
Really want to run that risk?
I say we make Rooney for this. I think we should lay it on him. He was near the car, he had her jewelry, the DA will love him for it.
Even if he didn't do it?
Who cares whether he did it? You have kids, Belmont? He needs to be taken permanently out of harm's way.
And we let Mueller slide?
For a while. He gets a free pass for now.
So basically, we could screw some guy over, even though he is a pedophile, but he didn't kill the woman. Or we can let the pedophile go and get the real murderer. So now you're starting to see pieces of corruption in the LAPD. Basically, the choice is for the greater good. Protect the children or protect one child. Pretty interesting. I mean, my first guess was way off. I thought those two were in it together, but I forgot the name of the fucking dad, that's why. Because I haven't played this in like 4 days. So yeah. It's pretty obvious Henry Mulder killed a woman. Alright, let's see how this plays out.
Go soft on me in here, Phelps.
We'll work the evidence, Rusty. Let him do the rest.
Interview room this way.
Are they ready?
Bowler's in two and the pervert's in one. Get in there and get a conviction.
Captain, we were on our way to interview Eli Rooney.
Yes, Phelps, I know. This particular fiend is an old acquaintance. I have tried to reaffirm his belief in a wrathful and terrible God. Whichever way it goes, I'll be dealing personally with him.
You look like you've had it rough.
You see me asking for your sympathy, boy?
So if we even don't convict this dude, the captain's gonna take care of him anyway.
You're down on your luck, Eli.
I had worse. My family ate roadkill during the Dust Bowl.
But you have a job. A parolee has to have a job, correct?
I had me a job down in San Pedro. I'm looking for something new.
This place you worked have a name?
Hennessy Marine. You can't miss the place. Big yellow letters HM out front.
They give you any workwear, Eli?
Sure. Green coverall. Dang thing was hot. Felt like I was back in the pen wearing it.
It's funny how that works out. HM Marine and Henry Mulder. So they're really trying to trick me here. Let's go with the access to the braided rope.
You ever tie up any of your victims, Eli?
It's not a nice thing to go calling them.
What would you call them?
My girlfriend.
I can't say. I learned a long time ago not to go talking about the things I like. Talking about it just seems to get people's dander up.
Answer the goddamn question, Rooney, before I brain you.
See what I mean? Short answer is yes.
You have any preference regarding rope, Eli?
I know a good rope from a bad rope, if that's what you mean. That's not what you mean, is it? Any old rope will do me fine.
Farm boy like you, Eli, must prefer McGay for roping, am I right?
I prefer braid, tie hitching braid. It stays tight.
You killed Mrs. Mulder and stole her jewelry.
That ain't so. I ain't done nothing like that.
You have no job and nowhere to live by the smell of things. And you need money. You've been in trouble before, Eli. Who do you think a jury will believe?
I've been in trouble for other things, but I ain't never killed no one. I saw that car coming to the parking lot late last night. Man got changed there and put his coveralls in the trunk. I saw him drop the butterfly in the lamplight and he strolled out, cool as you like. And I went over and I picked it up.
Hmm. Let's go talk to the other dude.
Mr. Rooney. All it will take now is some paperwork.
Let's go talk to the other dude.
For my money, Hugo Moeller's our number one suspect. The evidence is solid. I think it's time we hit him.
Oh, shit. I don't, where's I don't interview room two? I guess on the other side of the this place.
Here's where we stand, Hugo. Your next-door neighbor heard screaming coming from your house. You were burning your blood-stained shoes. You have no one who can confirm your whereabouts last night. Your daughter says you're a violent man. We have everything we need to send you to death row, and all you have to say for yourself is, I didn't do it.
I swear I didn't kill her. Give me that lie test. I can prove it.
All right, disposal of evidence.
Why did you burn your shoes, Hugo?
Because I knew you'd never believe me.
Believe what?
It's rabbit's blood. A guy at work brought them in and I helped him skin them.
We could have just tested it for analysis.
Do you know anything about ropes, Hugo?
As much as the next man. I was a scout. I learned some more in the army.
I doubt him.
You learned to strangle with the rope in the army?
With rope, with my bare hands, but mainly with wire. I learned a lot of things in the army, but I still didn't kill my wife.
For argument's sake, what type of rope would you use?
If I had to, I would use a triple braid. Less flex, easier to control.
We found your wife's car. Someone parked it at the school late last night. Do you have anything to say about that?
It wasn't me.
Where do you keep your work clothes?
I keep them at work in my locker.
Enough lies, Hugo. Your overalls put you at the scene of the crime last night.
My overalls are in the laundry of my house.
Green overalls, bloodstain, with the initials HM, found in the trunk of your wife's car.
They can't be mine.
Why, Hugo? Because if they were yours, they'd be in the incinerator too?
Your wife was beaten with a tire iron, Hugo. An appropriate choice of tool for a mechanic.
I know nothing about any tire iron.
You're lying, Hugo. You're gonna have to come clean on this.
You got no proof.
Your wife drove a Chevrolet, Hugo. What make of car do you drive?
A Chrysler Airflow.
So I guess that explains why the tire iron that killed your wife came from a Chrysler.
So basically, I had to make a decision, huh? Whoop! Rank 14. I don't know what this shit does other than unlock stuff. What do you think?